For 400,000 generations, not years, generations, our ancestors has lived as hunter-gatherers. So they lived in small groups and they shared everything. Because those groups were extremely egalitaristic and nobody was, I mean, nobody got more than anybody else. So actually our biology is still the same. It hasn't changed much or at all. And we are built to share. And we feel good when we share, actually. Because the original state of human being is a group state, being in the group. And Western civilization has slowly, from 12th century, during the Renaissance, has gotten more and more individualistic. And now, these times, it's everything. It's iPhone, iCar. We human always exchange favors. But if you exchange favor, that means that you do something good to somebody else. And then you have to remember this. Because you have to remember for every part of the group who is returning favors, who is giving favors, and what's the value of the favors given and taken and so on. And this is extremely complicated, but we do it without a problem because we developed our big brains just for this. And there was an English neurologist called Umber. He calculated that we, the maximum for this meaningful relationship our brain can handle at one time is 153. And then everybody says, oh, you see, it's only 153 meaningful relationships we can have at one single time. Yes, but let's turn this around. So to feel good, we must have 153 meaningful relationships. But do we have them?